The US has sent a clear message to Pakistan: stop siding with China or face the consequences. In a move depriving Pakistan of even the chance to save face, the US has banned Pakistan International Airlines from flying to the US. The US Department of Transportation has revoked permission for Pakistan International Airlines to conduct charter flights. The US cited concerns about almost one-third of Pakistani pilots having fake licenses, which was a revelation made by Pakistan's own aviation minister. The European Union has also banned PIA for 6 months. Islamabad, which is already reeling under the burden of a crippling debt crisis, a severe economic downturn, and global isolation, is losing the goodwill of the world. At a time when Chinese expansionism is facing global backlash, the world is also in no mood to let the Islamic Republic go scot-free for giving geopolitical and geostrategic aid to China. According to the European Foundation for South Asian Studies, an Amsterdam-based think tank has stated that Pakistan's regional machinations no longer figure at the top of Washington's strategic priorities. Rather, the US is preparing for the big battle for influence against China. Pakistan is no longer important to the US. In fact, it is part of the axis that the US frowns upon. We already know that, since the US State Department has designated it as a country of particular concern. The State Department recognizes that Pakistani madrasas reportedly continue to teach extremist doctrine. In fact, the State Department report had also stated that many madrasas failed to register with the government or provide documentation of their sources of funding, or to limit their acceptance of foreign students to those with valid visas, a background check, and the consent of their governments, as required by law. The report did recognize Islamabad's role in the US-Taliban peace dialogue, but it also took cognizance of the perfidious role that Islamabad played in Afghanistan by supporting terror groups active in the war-torn country. The report further asserted, Afghanistan continued to face significant challenges in protecting its borders, particularly those with Pakistan and Iran. The US has been a friend of Pakistan for decades, making several exceptions for the country. But now, Washington has been drawing itself away from Pakistan, having recognized the devious role that Islamabad played against American interests in their fight against the Taliban. This was the reason why Donald Trump hammered Pakistan with aid cuts when he came to power. Pakistan has been facing backlash in the United States, especially after Osama bin Laden was found and eliminated by American forces in Pakistan's Abbottabad. Fun fact, Pakistan's Prime Minister Imran Khan recently called Osama bin Laden a shaheed or a martyr in the country's joke of a parliament. And in the changing geopolitical context and the growing centrality of the Indo-Pacific, Islamabad is positioning itself for still greater fury. Islamabad is a rogue player that is helping another rogue player, Beijing, in achieving its geostrategic goals. The US, along with other like-minded countries like India, Japan, and Australia, wants to contain Chinese influence in the region and encircle it from all corners so that China remains a green water navy and its expansionist tendencies are tackled efficiently. But Pakistan is creating loopholes in the global encirclement of China. The China-Pakistan Economic Corridor, which starts from Chinese province of Xinjiang and passes through Pakistan-occupied Indian territories of Gilgit-Baltistan and Pakistan-occupied Kashmir, gives China direct access to the Balochistan province and the Gwadar port in Pakistan, where China is building a naval base. Islamabad's actions of supporting China have global implications. All countries that oppose China's salami-slicing tactics, which denote growing expansionism in the South China Sea and the Himalayas, are opposed to what Islamabad is up to, because Pakistan is putting China's adversaries in a spot of bother. Pakistan cannot afford to have an independent foreign policy because it is deeply burdened with external debt, particularly the debt obligations towards China. Willingly or unwillingly, it is falling into an informal axis of countries like Turkey and Iran that Beijing is trying to create. This makes the Islamic Republic a bigger outcast than it already is. The US and the world are ignoring and sidelining Pakistan like never before. The message to Pakistan is loud and clear: stop siding with China or prepare to get obliterated from the global scene.